sisters demand. I'm back, y'all. I am back. It's your girl, Mysterious Jax. Oh my God, it feels so good to be back in the studio. Oh, yes. Oh my God, you are now tuned into the Ladies Night Radio Show. It's your girl, Mysterious Jax, coming to you live from the Good News Studio. Also here with me on my beautiful, crazy, and on time, ladies.
Hey, everyone.
It's your girl, Crazy Maria, in the house. As you know, the party's about to get started because I'm in the house. So tune in. Make sure that you guys enjoy the show.
Hey, guys. It's your girl, Myra. Hope you guys are ready for this dope-ass show. We got Jackie back. We're
yes!
so excited.
And she's on the board, so we're about to see some different shit go on. Everything's about to be on point and on tune.
That's right. That's right. I am on the board. Of course, you know how that goes. Oh my God, it's so good to be back. Like, I'm not even kidding.
We've missed you, girl.
I had a blank right now. My brain had a brain fart, I guess it's called, because I was like, I pressed play and I couldn't hear us, but that's why I had Myra check. We're good though.
We're good.
All right. Just I was like, oh my God, I've been off the air for like 2 weeks that I forgot how to do this. What's going on? It's all good, though. It's all good. The ladies are back.
Let's go, girl.
We right here. Happy Friday. It is about a few days before Christmas. What, 5 days before Christmas. It's December 20th, 2019. This is episode 56 of Ladies Night. And today happens to also be my mom's birthday. So shout out to my mom. Aww. Happy birthday, Mom.
Happy
I love
birthday,
you.
Mamacita chula.
How are you guys doing? How has it been so far?
Oh, okay. Now I'm on.
There we go. Yeah, you were on.
I couldn't hear
you. You know what? I put down your volume because you guys were kind of yelling, but can you hear it now?
Yes, good? Now.
Normally,
yes.
I'm the loud ass in here. So yeah.
I put you down, too. All right. So there we go. So, yeah, how's it been? How was the show without me here? Were you guys nervous when I wasn't here? Because you know what happens.
Yeah, I was having nightmares leading up to
Tell them what your nightmare was. I don't know if you said it on air last time, but tell them what your nightmare was.
No, I didn't. Just talking about it is going to make me feel like it really happened because it was like crazy.
Okay. Well, no, it did. I heard the show back. You guys did an awesome job. The only thing I will say is I think Maria left herself and Anna on mute. You were fine, but Maria and Anna were on mute. What it sounded like the whole time. I don't know if
really?
You went to go. Did you go back and listen to it?
I have not yet.
It sounds completely. Okay, so her sounds, like her talking, sounds different from how you were talking. So I could tell like they were on mute or they were really low.
You're right. It did. Even when we were on air, I felt we all sounded different. I think mine sounded okay, but I think everybody else sounded different.
Yes.
When we were on air, I heard it.
And yeah. I mean, it happens. You know, shout out to Maria. It was her third time doing it and her first time doing it without any help from me and Kosi. So she held it down. It sounded good. I know that you were multitasking and I was like, there was no sounds in the background, no music. I was like, oh, she must have been on one.
That is true. I sound a little low right now, but Keith did hit me up in my on my text messages telling me that I sounded really far away and to get close. And so I thought I fixed it, but apparently not. But I did try. So I hope you guys enjoyed that show. It was a little nerve wracking because it is a big, big deal when you're pretty much hosting the show and running the board at the same time.
I mean, besides the technical parts, you guys had really good conversation. The topic was jealousy. Mm-hmm. And you guys had, Kosi had set up a lot of great questions for you guys to answer on air. And it, you guys did a good job. So shout out to also our special guest co-host, Anna, little Anna I call her, who held it down. So good job, you guys. You guys did a great job. I'm not going to lie, though. I was not listening to you guys live. I was living my best life in New Orleans.
Okay. Partying it up. I was not either.
I'm not even going to lie. New Orleans. I had Nolens. Man, I had a fun-ass time in New Orleans.
I'm sure we're going to hear all about it in a few, girl. Sharing what stays in New Orleans does not stay in New Orleans because it is ladies' night, so you got to get the tea.
Girl, we need that tea.
So there is some tea that happened in New Orleans. I mean, I had a good-ass time. I'm not even going to lie. The food is out there. The food is amazing. And so... I don't know if you guys know, but I did a challenge with Keith where I'm not eating any red meat, like no pork, no beef, no chicken. The only thing that I was going to eat was fish. So pretty much I was going to be pescatarian until I think it was like second to last week of November until January 1st. And I did really good. I didn't eat meat for about 3.5, almost 4 weeks. And then I literally had meat when I got back to LA, and it just kind of happened. It was actually last Friday, a week ago, I had my first like taste of meat, and it happened because we went to a movie screening. So shout out to Jorge, who invited the ladies to his movie screening, and we went, and he had free drinks, free food, and one of the foods that he had there was tortas ahogadas, and oh my god, like I was like, of course I want one, sure, let me try. And then it has chicken in it, and I was like, oh my god, I just ate meat. So I was like, fuck it. And then we went and had food and I had chicken again. So, but I'm going back. No more meat, just seafood. But
are you going to start in January?
No, until January.
Oh. You're like, no, girl, I got 2 weeks.
Hey, sometimes people go backwards. It's okay. I'm going to start again. But
When you were in New Orleans, you didn't mess
no
up at all?
No meat, nothing.
Okay. No animal meat.
You want to know why? Because they're known for seafood. I had catfish. I had oysters. Yes. I had shrimp. I had all the seafood. Yeah. I didn't worry about the meat.
So I got a question for you.
Yes.
Because you know I was watching.
Okay.
You had some jambalaya rice. Was there any meat in that? Okay.
There wasn't.
Okay. Look at the vegan over here.
But the flavor was in there. But I know there was like, because everybody makes jambalaya different. Yeah. Everybody makes.
But you're not vegan, so you don't have to worry about there being animal product in it. You just, there wasn't meat in it.
So I'm not eating meat because of the animals, even though I love animals, but it's more just a challenge. Like, like something like right now, Keith is doing a challenge for himself where he's not smoking or drinking. So it's more of like a cleanse. Yeah. So right now until for 30 days, I think January something, he's not smoking or drinking.
That's awesome.
He wanted me to do that challenge with him too, but I was in New Orleans. I was like, dude, I'm already giving up meat. Like, I'm not going to give up alcohol. Like, it's like mini Vegas. Oh, you guys, we have to take a ladies trip to New Orleans. We have to.
I'm down.
Next
plus summer. You guys had a big game out there.
Yes.
I mean, I know you're not a New Orleans fan.
No.
But I know that you hang out, and that's like the whole purpose of this huge trip that you guys did.
Yeah.
But it was pretty huge out there. So there was no way that you could go on without alcohol out there.
True. New Orleans is like a Vegas. Like somebody said it's like Vegas's ghetto stepsister. I don't know why. But it's because the streets smell like piss, and it's like, you know, there's just people like passed out on the sidewalks that are like OD'd. So it's a little crazy.
OD'd.
Yeah, they out there doing some drugs out there. But, so it's not common. It's not, you're going to see somebody just pass out on every corner, but it happens. It's not a surprise. It's a beautiful city. It's very welcoming. Everybody out there is really nice. And something that somebody told me when I was leaving is that the touristy places are very welcoming. I mean, the whole city is, but especially those because... and you're also going to be really safe. There's a lot of undercover policemen that are in the Frenchman Street and Bourbon Street, and they're making sure everything's like good because they want all the tourists to make sure they're taken care of. Yeah. They want the tourists to come back because that's how they make their money. That's how they're rebuilding their city, is by the tourists that are going. And if they want to make sure you have a great time, you want to come back, you tell your friends, the food, like everybody was so nice. And I'm not saying it was just the touristy places, but they did say, like, you know, when you go in the local places, you're kind of like, it's not as safe. But the touristy places where we were at, Frenchman Street, Bourbon Street, downtown, it's so many police officers and so many people from like different cities. So everybody there is like a tourist, kind of like Vegas. When you go to Vegas, the Strip, it's filled with tourists, and that's how New Orleans is. But it's just a different vibe from Vegas. Like the difference is like every bar is so close to each other, so you can literally just go bar hopping or different restaurants or lounges or cafes. Even their coffee shops sold coffee drinks with alcohol. I remember at like I think at like 2 p.m. I was like, oh, I need coffee. We went to this coffee shop and I got my coffee with like 3 shots of Jameson, and it was so good. It was like a gingerbread latte with 3 shots of Jameson.
That sounds good.
And it was so good.
I would have that.
And so it was like a whole menu of like coffees, but with alcohol in it.
Was it really sweet?
There was like Bailey's. Some of them were sweet.
Because I'm not a sweet.
Well, that's why Jameson's not sweet, right? So those strong shots. And then gingerbread latte, it is sweet, but with the mix of it, it was like a perfect combination. Because I don't really like sweet drinks either, but it was really good. So every place you went, there's like Fat Tuesdays. There's like the big drinks, like it's just so fun. And then the people I went with, I have a good time. So every bar that you go to, like 95% of them are free. Like 98% of them are free. We only paid one time, which was $5 to get in. But it was this like DJ, I guess, that's known downtown or whatever. And he was playing a dance hall, reggae, and just hip hop. And literally that club is, or the bar, is the one bar that got my whole group dancing. And we all have different types of like music that we like, but that bar had us all dancing. And we went with like a mixed group of people, you know, there was like white, Latino, black, and all of us were dancing in that. We were all came out sweating, and it was so funny because we're all kind of like, you know, in our 30s and older, and
tired.
And so we all got down at one point. We're all low, right? We're all like freaking bent over, hands on the knees, like just getting down. And then you just see all of us grabbing a chair to get back up, like our asses were so low. Oh my god,
going to sleep with ice packs on your knees.
No, for real. One of my guy friends, he had taken ibuprofen 800 because, you know, he has some like aches, body aches. And my back was killing me at first because we walked so much. So we were like, I was like, hey, can I get some? I would text him like, because we all had different hotels. I was like, can you bring some to Frenchman Street when I see you? Because I need it. My back is killing me. But it was funny because we were like trying to hang. And then the first night I got there. Okay. So part of our show is I'm going to talk a lot about my New Orleans trip because I just – it's going to go into today's topic. So let me just kind of tell you. So if you're kind of just tuning in, today's topic is, you know, pretty much finding – am I the only one that, like, gets booed up on vacation? Because this always happens. Yes. So that's the chisme today and also
it
the topic.
It seems like it, huh? It's,
I don't know. I haven't been with Jackie on a trip.
Do
but
people
damn.
Get booed up on their vacations? Or is that just a Jackie thing? And I have to explain the booed up part. Like, I'll tell you guys that more of later. But that and also another topic is when you meet somebody, you like you just met them, you're like you're flirting. And it can be, I'm going to tell you, a week, a month, a day, and you guys are talking or dating. And then you get introduced to their friend, and you're feeling their friend more, or their friend is feeling you. When is it, or is there a proper way to successfully move on to their friend? You know what I mean? So I'm going to explain that, too. It goes with my story. You guys got to tune in a little bit later. That's gonna, I'm going to talk about that later. But right now, I'm just kind of talking about my trip. Then we're going to go into the chisme, and then we're going to play a quick game. And then we're going to go into the topic. I'm like so much that I want to catch up with you guys. Tune into the chat box. Please make let me know I'm not the only one that, you know, this happens to. I got some New Orleans music in the background. This is also one of my favorite parts, guys, is the live music and live bands that are on the streets just playing. It just gets the whole streets going. It's so fun. Okay, really quick. On my flight to New Orleans, I was flying by myself, and I sat next to these two gentlemen. And so I was on the aisle seat, and they had the window and the middle seat. And then to my right were these two women, and they had, like, first-class seats. This plane was a little interesting. And so they were to my right. So two gentlemen to my left, two ladies to my right. They happened to be married, the couples. So I was sitting between the husband and the wives, pretty much. And it was a very fun flight. They were interesting. The girls were just chatting. They were catching up. So I talked most of to their husbands. And they loved, ended up like hanging with me and loving it and talking to me. They ended up buying me my drinks all through the flight. So they bought me Jack Daniels throughout the flight. And I probably only had three, but I wasn't mixing them. And I ended up getting really tipsy. So by the time I got off the flight, I knew that we had to have dinner plans. So I'm at dinner, and I'm telling my friends, like, yo, these guys got me so drunk on the flight. Like, I'm already hung over at dinner. Like, after this. And it was, like, I was already, like, 8 o'clock, 9 o'clock. And they were like, what? Like, I was like, they didn't believe me. Because I was like, they're like, Jackie, how are you already hung over? You just landed. And I was like, I know. Long story short, I was not going to go out. And I ended up just saying, like, I'm going to go straight to the hotel. You guys have fun on Bourbon Street. And, you know, because I've already been there. Two of the girls had not. And then they order me coffee. They're like, Jackie, you are not going back to the hotel. You're coming out with us. By this time, it's already 9:30. And I'm like, guys, I'm tired. They're like, doesn't matter. I was like, and I'm a little hungover. They gave me Advil, coffee, and they're like, you're ready to go. And long story short, I did. So it was like, all right. So one of the girls was like, Jackie, I'll go out with you. We'll just go for one of the bars and then we'll go to the hotel. Cool, we'll share an Uber. Girl, why did one bar turn into like 8 bars? And we did not get home till 8 in the morning.
What?
I mean, sorry, 4 in the morning, 4 in the morning.
I'm like 8 in the morning.
4 in the morning. But still, 4 in the morning's late.
I hate that. One thing I hate is to get back home before the sun gets back. I do not like to get back home before the sun goes up. Like, that is not.
I've done that in Vegas. You've never done that in Vegas?
You get home.
Lies. Because you be in the casino. And
I do, but exactly. I hate that. I don't like that.
You get home after the sun comes up?
No, I get home before. So okay. I like to be home or in my room by at least 1 or 2 in the morning. I do not like to get back in the room 4, 5, 6. I lose sleep. And for me, sleep is so, like, important that I can't. I just hate that. So, yeah, that's
you're
not
lying because you know you go back to the room like at 6 in the morning in Vegas.
No, I promise
I've been
you,
with you,
but I don't. I don't know.
We're
gonna
have to. We're gonna have to test out this theory maybe next summer.
Oh
hey.
No!
Hey. No. I don't know, Myra. I don't know,
nah, girl. Shut up. We'll be there.
All right,
ladies' night
this summer coming up. I got
yeah,
you. Ladies
summer.
Going to
ladies' night
Vegas.
Going where to Vegas,
yes,
New Orleans.
Ladies going to Vegas.
Okay.
You got that.
Hey, we're going to do our live show in Vegas.
Yep.
Stay tuned.
Live show. Yeah, you got it. Okay.
So there's so much that I want to share about this trip, and I'm going to cut into pieces. But just long story short, for this first night, we went to like 8 bars. And on our way to like to one of the bars, I ran into the guys that it's actually the first bar in the United States ever is in New Orleans. The first bar ever built is in New Orleans. And that's what it's called. I don't know what it's called, but it's. Anyways, the first bar, I'm walking and we're all buzzed. It's like 3:30 in the morning. And all of a sudden I see the two guys that got me drunk on the plane outside the bar. And I'm like, my friends. And they're like, friend. And I was like, guys, this is the two guys. And then one of my guy friends that I was walking with who was also tipsy. He's like, yo, bro, for reals, we really thought she was bullshitting. We didn't think you guys were real. I was like, where are your wives? And they're like, they're inside. And I went to go give them a hug. And one of the wives came out. She was like, I need to take a picture of you guys. I need to take a picture. And she took a picture of us. So all my friends jumped in the picture as well. And so I have that picture. I'll probably post it on my story later. But yeah, the first night was really fun. But the first night actually also led to me meeting somebody that I'm going to share that story a little bit later in the show. So stay tuned for that. FYI, Maria and Meyer don't know this story yet either.
We
I wanted to
not,
keep it fresh for the show, for y'all, for yes. the listeners. Cause
girl, cuéntame. Cuéntame.
And just FYI, before I go on, have you guys ever met somebody on vacation?
I mean, come on, girl.
Cozy says yes.
I have.
I have not. Mm-hmm. I mean, I started early in my marriage, so I have not
okay.
at all.
All
so
right.
That's one. Another one for the book.
All right.
One nice
on
then. Haven't done it. And then now that
well,
one.
Let's get into some chisme,
not
y'all.
The books on the list.
Well, for the books.
Yo tengo una clase de chisme de otro mundo.
Oh.
No me diga, nena. Cuéntame.
Hey, chisme. I got some cheese in for y'all. Okay, so to impeach or not to impeach?
Oh,
so
Lord.
Everyone is talking about the impeachment of Donald Trump. He has become the third president to be impeached. Did you guys know that?
Mm-hmm.
He's
do you
not
know?
Impeached yet.
No, he is impeached.
No,
but
it still
I'm
going to
explain
go through,
more.
Okay.
But he is impeached. He's impeached of Donald, and so he's the third president to be impeached.
Right.
The first two being Andrew Jackson and Bill Clinton. So Bill Clinton was impeached, but he stayed as president. Just FYI, too. Mm-hmm. So he was impeached, but he stayed as president because, and I'll explain him a little bit more. Trump's impeachment comes after the House of Representatives voted on Wednesday. Now, I'm sure a lot of people are expecting him to be removed from office because that's what impeachment means, right? Wrong. So let me break it down for you. So he has, so he was impeached on charges of abusing his position of power and obstructing Congress. It starts with the House who vote. Then it has to go to trial with the Senate for another vote. So yes, there's grounds to remove him from office, but the Senate has to make that final vote. And who currently has more seats in the Senate right now? You guessed it, the Republicans. Mm-hmm. So we shall see how this ends. So any prediction, ladies, of how you think this will happen or this how this will end? What do you think? Do you think that Trump is going to finish and stay president?
Yes.
Or do you think he's going to get impeached?
Nah, he's going to stay.
He's going to stay? What about you?
I said it last time when we brought this up in the Chisme. He's not going to get impeached. He has a huge.
No, Maria, Republican. He is impeached.
I get they voted for his impeachment and so it went through, but it's not going to be complete.
He hasn't been removed from office.
He's not going to.
But he's impeached.
Okay. He's not going to go nowhere.
There's like three there's
steps.
Yeah,
yes.
but he's been impeached.
Right.
By his peers.
He's not going anywhere.
You mean removed from the office?
Because the Republicans are not going to vote for him to leave.
Right.
And it still has to go through, correct me if I'm wrong, the Senate?
He has to have his trial.
So he's not going to be removed because he has a huge fan base in that Republican era or side. And I don't think he's going to go anywhere. Oh, okay, girl, tell me to shut the fuck up.
She's like, bitch, he's getting removed.
No, I hate him just as much as you guys do, but I don't think he's going anywhere. And I think that he knows he's not going anywhere. That's why he's being so fucking arrogant.
Right now, he's
a
little hurt. He's just hurt. His ego's hurt.
His ego is hurt.
His ego is hurt by the process.
Well,
but he knows that he's not going anywhere.
I think for me, it just gets me upset that he even made it to presidency. And it's going to be in the books for, like, his grandkids and all that to be like, oh, my grandfather was my great-grandfather, my great-great-whatever was the president.
Let's say he doesn't get removed.
He doesn't deserve it.
Is he going to get a second term?
Well, that's a good one, too. Cosey does not think that
Cosey's like, hell no.
You can give him the mic if you want.
No. I don't know because we thought he wasn't going to make it to presidency, and he did. For me, I feel like he absorbed all this shit that was like under the dirt and underground, all these people that were like, you know, like, oh, I really care about you or I really care about colored people. And once he became president, it's like, yeah, fuck them black and brown people. Like, it just really brought up some whole different, all the fucking racist people, it just brought them up. So I really do believe, because our vote doesn't count, and I really do believe that he's going to come back.
All right, Cosey, what are you going to say? Producer Cosey, get on the mic.
I don't think that he's going to make it to a second term because I feel like we're at a state right now where, like, if he makes it to the second term, our country will literally be on fire. We will be in a revolution. And I don't think our country is ready for that. So I feel like he will not make it to a second term based on all the bullshit that's happening right now. And as far as him not being president in the first place, I felt like he was going to win. It was, so when I was watching the election, like the election process, I never felt like, okay, this person is not going to be our president. Yeah. I was literally scared.
Or at least he didn't have a chance.
It's going to happen. But I do feel like because we have experienced so many years with him that, And the fucking house was like, no, like, you gotta go.
From the beginning, they've been.
I honestly, when we were voting, I didn't think that he was gonna make it. I thought that Hillary was gonna win before him.
I felt like he was gonna make it.
Because Hillary had, you know, her husband as a backup, so I never thought that he was gonna make it.
Our country's not ready for a female president, I'm sorry.
But I feel like it's almost the same thing as what happened to Bush.
We're
right?
ready. It's just these men aren't ready.
Right, mm-hmm. Exactly.
They don't wanna see a woman president.
They would do anything to not have a woman president. And so that's why I was like, I know Trump is going to win. But now we're at the crossroads, and I feel like he will not get a second
term. Did you hear how all the Republicans were threatening a potential civil war if he gets impeached or removed. Like, they were going to, like,
yeah,
have
I heard
a whole
that.
Fit and start, they were going to riot, like, start a whole civil war. Like, that's what they said
yeah.
on when they were getting interviewed.
Yeah, I heard that too.
If he gets removed.
Motherfuckers. Come on, it's too many of us.
At the end of the day, even if he does get impeached, even if he gets removed, guess who we have left? Pence. And he is worse than Trump. So
yes, exactly. I just said that the other day.
Exactly. So, all right. Well, that moving on to the next chisme of the night. Kim K looks black? Question mark. So you know who Amanda Seales is, right? She's a hilarious comedian who stars on HBO Insecure, a number of other shows, and also has a stand-up comedy special on Netflix. And she's very vocal on Instagram. And she will be the fifth member of The Real next year. This is just breaking news, oh, by the way, from producer Cozy. If you do know her, you're aware that she's a huge feminist and very pro-black in the sense of speaking up on matters that affect black women. So when Kim K came out in Seven Hollywood magazine, a few shades darker, did you guys see it? Amanda mm-hmm. called her out for wearing blackface and of culture appropriation. So we have a clip for you. I'm going to go ahead and play it for y'all. Just want to mute Drake real quick. And play this for y'all of what she said on her Instagram. So if you want to watch the whole video, because I'm only going to play a little bit. Yeah, check out her Instagram, Amanda Seales. Where did I put it? Oh, wait, it's over here. There we go. All right, here we go.
Commodify. This is a constant thing that they do. For real. And there will be people who will be like, oh my gosh, you know, there's bigger topics to talk about, Amanda. There's more important things to say. First of all, I'm a black woman and I'm going to determine when a topic about black women is valid and important enough for me to talk about. And as a black woman, to see this person on this cover in blackface, and yes, you can call it tan or bronzer or whatever, but again, she don't care. She don't care.
Whoa. So that's pretty much what she's saying. She goes on to say that they inject their lips, their hips, their booties to mimic ours. They attempt our style and they give nothing back. It's all depletion with no replenishment, end quote. So that's all she put on her Instagram. There's more on there. Like I said, it's a really long video. Check it out if you want to hear the rest of it. So this is a tough one. So did Kim really do cultural appropriation with this photo shoot that she, you know, put out there in this picture, or is Amanda reaching? Regardless, there are ways to appreciate a culture without being inappropriate. And if you are influenced by a culture, own that shit. So Cozy wanted me to ask you guys, how can we keep our teams accountable for things like this, whether or not it's cultural appropriation, and who is checking to make sure it isn't? So, you know, if Ladies Night ever became really successful, you know, who's on our team to make sure that we're not being, that we're being culturally, you know, sensitive and that we're not disrespecting anybody, even though, like, you know, like, I think Cozy's biggest thing is, like, if you're ever, if your style, if you, your personality is, I want to say, influenced by other cultures, I think you should shout them out and give them credit of where you got it. So, like, if we, you know, wore, like, Asian attire, or we're starting to bring Asian, you know, things, cultures into our show or stuff, and we're gonna try to say, oh, Ladies Night came up with it, like, no, we found this at such and such, this is the where we got it. I think at the end of the day, people want the credit of, and also where you're influenced from. Like, don't try to act like you're the one that made it up or made it relevant or made it cool and stuff. At the end of the day, that's kind of what this frustration is. And I totally love Amanda Seales. I think that, you know, she's a great advocate for that community. But I want to say that, do you guys think that in this picture she is looking or trying to look black? Or do you think that in this certain image, Amanda is reaching for something?
I haven't listened to the video. I haven't listened to what she explained. But when I glanced at that, Kim Kardashian looks like a light-skinned black woman.
Mm-hmm.
That's what she looks like to me.
I had to a double take. I was like, I thought it was a drag queen. I was like, who is this? I thought it was like RuPaul or something.
She almost looks, I mean, but you can tell I mean, someone had to look at that picture and think, okay, this might offend someone. Someone might reach, maybe, you know, quote unquote.
But I mean,
but why not? I don't know. She obviously thought she it was okay, and she put it. She let them put it out.
Do you guys remember Jersey Shore? What is their saying when they in that show?
I didn't watch it.
It was Gym Tan Laundry.
Oh yeah,
GTL, yeah. Was that it? Gym Tan Laundry.
But they're from Jersey.
You know what's funny is that I thought the same thing.
But that's what I was gonna say. Who remembers how dark Snooki was at one point and JWoww? Like Snooki, I remember one. And I will say Snooki's adopted, but she's Latina, but she still identifies as what,
Italian. Yeah.
She doesn't recognize herself as Latina, even though now she's starting to a little bit more. But there was an episode where she came out so burnt.
I remember that one.
And I was like, that's what, and I remember back when I was like early 2000s, I would go to tanning booths and I would tan. And I remember looking at a picture and I was like, I look so burnt in one of mine.
But there's a big difference.
There is.
Because they look like people from Jersey that are super tan. That's what they look like. They look, they still have the Jersey style.
But there's so many, I don't want to say like, well, white girls, but like there's so many women out here. We live by the beach. So they are, they're tanning thing is a big thing.
I tan a lot during the summer. I get really bronze, but I'm not.
No, do you go to an actual tanning booth?
No.
I used to live in the valley.
I think for Amanda's what styles is also because these girls are wearing the whole, what do you call those, lace fronts? You know, they're wearing the weaves. They're injecting their lips. They're injecting their butts.
And
they're getting.
No, but we're talking about this picture.
No, that's why I'm telling you.
This what picture in particular.
What Amanda Styles is getting to is like, girl, like you trying too much to look the part.
Out of all people, and Kim Kardashian is going to get it the most because this isn't her first rodeo.
Right.
And she's worn the braids and tried to say, oh, I'm like this and like that. And I've done it. She is known for being a culture snatcher.
Yes.
But my thing, too, is like Amanda has probably been in the rooms with her in some sort. Why doesn't she call her out in her face?
That is true. But I think,
and
I
so
think
my
also
thing is
because
like, I think Kim K is such an easy target. To like come for her because she don't say shit. She gonna look, even if you come to her face, she gonna look like in her corner. She gonna be looking
so
like
innocent.
Yeah,
so like, what?
Que hice?
Come on now,
I feel like she doesn't care.
She's airhead. Like she's missing some parts up there in her
she
head.
Can't be that much of an airhead if she's making millions of dollars.
Come on, her
she's
body
not that much of an airhead.
She used her body.
Cozy.
She's not smart.
I think that. I know that you're saying that. Yeah, tanning. We all tan. Blah blah blah. I've tanned before too. I think
you have.
I have.
Like at a tanning booth.
No, I've gone out, like, I'll put my shit
later. Oh, no, I'm talking about a tanning booth.
But whatever. I'm saying, like, I will tan, too. I understand the, like, appreciation of tanning. Mm-hmm. However, you need to understand the history. Like, you need to recognize, like, her actions, what she's done up until this point. Mm-hmm. So it's very easy for us to sit here and say,
I'm not lying. I'm not saying that. I'm not saying that she hasn't been that person. What I'm saying is this particular picture, we're talking about this picture. Yes, the braids, other things. I'm not saying that. She has appropriated a lot of the cultures, even the Asian culture
she has.
And so I'm not saying that she's not.
No, but she's gone through this culture a little bit more than any other culture.
I think that
all of her sisters actually
have. I think Amanda
have.
Is reaching on this.
I wouldn't call it blackface.
Yes, I wouldn't say blackface.
Yeah, that to me killed me. Yeah, I wouldn't call it blackface.
Let me tell you,
that's what I'm trying to say. I think she's reaching.
No, but she didn't say blackface. Blackface was already on the media.
But look, let me.
She didn't do it because I saw it on the Shade Room too.
Look, I am gonna say, I'm just glancing at this picture right
now. You don't even look like her.
She looks like a black woman.
Mm-hmm. Yes,
why
she does.
Would you let this come out and you
preach,
look like a
Myra,
black woman?
Yes.
Yeah.
Like
no,
on.
This is not me. This
the
is not
that,
who I
the
am.
The fact that Kim Kardashian doesn't give a fuck and she still let it come out, it to me is a slap in the face for black women, and it's disrespectful.
Do you think by any chance that she's also knowing this information because of the whole kimono, the thing with the, you know, that do you think that she does these things just to stay relevant because she's getting older
she
and now she
fuck.
Said she's not going to be posting as
fuck
she
that.
Has
look. She already got like a lot of respect. So now why continue to do shit that's going to backlash and bring your fucking name down?
Right.
You want to go out same. I'm a huge football fan. So Tony Romo, perfect example on the Cowboys. You want to go out the right way. You want to go out with respect. You don't want to go out where people be like, "Damn, that bitch
she's not,
stirred up a lot of shit."
This is not that same thing. You have to understand. How you just said it. How did she make money?
I'm with
by
her
a sex
fucking
tape.
Body. Yes.
A sex tape. That's
but
how
that's
she started.
Not, okay, but she already there is what I'm trying to tell you. She does not have to keep on doing
Maria,
stupid
she doesn't
like
think
this.
Like us, like Myra,
well,
like you.
She's not
like
smart, so don't say she's smart.
I never said she was smart, but I said she's making a lot of money. And
look,
there's when people
she's
that
not
are
dumb.
She's not dumb. Thank
una
you. She's not dumb.
Es
lo que
es. She is not dumb.
No, yes, she
and
is.
And let me tell you
she
something.
She is air
makes,
fucking headed.
Maria.
No. She yes. makes dumb decisions, yes. Yes.
This isn't a dumb
Pendeja.
Decision. This is a strategic,
yes.
respectful
decision. Are you kidding me,
Maria?
This is
a, Maria, you're not listening.
This is disrespectful in
Duh.
So many fucking
she,
ways.
This is a strategic, disrespectful decision. She
and
does
her kids
not,
are half black, and that's okay.
Yes.
Because she doesn't
that's
give a fuck.
Exactly.
So that's not
look
strategic.
At the type of, look at the type of husband
so then
she
who's,
has.
So that's
it
not
is
strategic.
Why would she put it out? If she cares, she wouldn't have put it out.
Guess what? She's on our Chisme, right?
That's she, not strategic.
Listen, she's on our Chisme, right?
Not on a good part.
Right.
Because we're bashing her.
And what do people say when they say good media or bad media? It's still no, it's something else. Not the word.
I disagree with that. I know what you're trying to say,
but I
disagree. I
can't
with
think
that.
Of the word. But anyways, Maria, you have to
because at one point her kids are going to grow up,
yes.
just like Donald stupid Trump, and they're going to hear the negative part of her fucking
so,
dumbass.
I will say this:
so she became famous off of fucking sex porn. Should her kids be happy about that? No, because guess what? Her kids are going to be able to Google that
yes.
shit and watch that shit, and they are not going to be happy. And at one point in her life, she's not going to be happy that she did that shit. Same
she's
as
already
all
saying
stupid,
she's
same
already
as
saying
the fucking
she's already
internet,
saying
stupid.
That she's not she's already saying that she's not gonna start posting those naked pictures anymore because of her kids.
Okay,
now she's saying that and she's
so
like
that's
almost 40.
That's what I'm trying to tell you. Like you, do
you're getting mad. That's what
down.
She wanted.
No,
she wanted that. You're
I'm
so
not
upset.
Mad.
That's
I
what
still
she
live
wanted.
My life.
She's over here looking. She's probably on
I'm
her phone,
mad.
Like
look,
reading
trust,
the comments
I'm
and
not
she's laughing.
I'm
You're
not mad.
Yelling. That's what I'm trying to say. Like, I
yeah.
get it.
Posey
I know.
Said move on.
Yeah, I know that. On. No, what I want to talk about this is because at the end of the day, this is what she wanted. And it gets you mad. It gets Cosey mad. And I'm not agreeing with her.
I'm
not
I'm
defending.
Not mad.
Okay.
I just know that
Cosey
her
took
name,
off her headphones and threw the mic. Like, I don't want to talk no, about this.
It's just
and
so
then,
loud.
And then
no,
you're
I was
yelling.
Speaking,
yes.
And I wasn't
Well, that's what happens on radio. Everybody starts talking. But if you want something to say, go ahead. You got it? Okay. So
I,
then
I agree. I agree with Cosey. Like on
no,
what
of
she
course
has
I agree with
say.
All of you. But what I'm yeah. trying to say is, like, I think you and I understood where we understand what she's doing.
Mm-hmm.
She's not dumb. She knows what she's doing with this. But I think at the end of the day, like, at the end of the day, the Kardashian family already have this like bubble around them where people don't like them, right? So it makes it really easy for people to come for them. Look, I'm not like say defending them. I'm just trying to put out there the facts.
I get it.
They're not liked, and it's they make it really easy for people to come for them. And I think when they do certain things like this, it's strategic for you to keep talking about them
yeah.
and making them relevant because the show has how many seasons?
That's what they want.
Exactly.
I get it.
Exactly. So but at the end of the day, she's not doing anything hateful or bad or like killing people or stealing. But it's just keeping her name relevant.
But
in a negative way, yes. But at the end of the day, it's still keeping them relevant. And they're still in the conversation.
I think Amanda Seals is right for calling her
yeah,
out
of
on
course.
It.
That, of
but
course.
I, but
of
I
course.
Know for a fact
maybe not 100%
she might be she reaching.
Said. Kim Kardashian does not give a fuck. She saw that image and she saw the same thing we all see. And she didn't care.
But, right.
But she posted it anyway.
Can
right.
I just
so
add my last two
the,
cents
she
and
does
I'm going to be
care.
Done. So I saw... on the Shade Room and, you know, other videos of Diddy's 50th birthday. And I saw how they walked in and, you know, you got Kylie and you got, what's her name, Chloe, and you got Kim. And I'm just watching them walking in and they just, like, taking pictures. Now I'm thinking in my head. This is just me. I'm thinking in my head and I'm like, I know all them motherfuckers around there. Or most of them are probably like, here come these hoes. Look, look, there go Chloe. Oh, Kylie. Oh, yeah, she look good. I'm going to go ahead and talk to her and get her to go ahead and suck my nuts for a bit. Or, you know, Chloe. Like, they be reaching high, right? Like, oh, okay, I'm going to go ahead and get with the basketball player. I'm going to go ahead and get that rapper. Like, though they have that. And you know what? For me, I'd rather have my name and just have the respect than have what they have. And I'm just talking, like, honestly. Like, you cannot... And they got kids. Like, you cannot be proud of something like what they have formed. And they started off pretty good with the whole Kardashian shit. But at this point where they're at, with the amount of, you know, situations that they've been through and relationships and all that, they're not in a respectful place. And if people talk about them, it's not out of respect. It's more out of just like just...
I get you. I get what you're saying. I get what you're saying. I'm very private about my business. I think all of us in this room are. We don't share much. And we've had to learn to share a little bit more and more because we're on radio and people, if you want them to connect to you, you have to do that. But at the end of the day, we live in a life, in a time where it's all about like a show pretty much. Social media, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. It's a show and everybody wants a reality show. So all those shows that you watch as far as like Housewives and, you know, Love and Hip Hop.
Don't put my business out there, Jackie. Come on now.
I mean, there's people out there that listen to watch it too. I don't watch it. I have other shows, but you and I used
I used to watch TV,
it.
But that is
okay, listen.
That
you're losing the point of it. Love and Hip Hop and all those reality shows. What keeps you keep watching it? Why? Because of the drama.
But can
the,
I say?
Wait, no. You said it. Of the drama is it's entertaining. So some people like that. Some people love
right.
drama in general. So if they can get paid for it, hey, that's what they're there for. So I'm not saying that I agree with that lifestyle. I probably wouldn't, and I probably will never be a billionaire like Kylie because I can never put my full on business out there like that. But at the end of the day, these women do it, and they know what sells. And the fact that we're like they're a topic in our show,
they're going to continue doing it,
so,
not care about anybody
exactly. And at the end of the day, it's like their mind is like they're going to play tontas, of course. But like, what do you mean? I did like I didn't mean to offend you, but no, they did. They did know what they were doing, like
absolutely.
Myra said. They knew when they put this picture out what it was going to start. And at the end of the day, they're not blackface. But they are fucking super dark tan. And then they have the wigs, like you said. And they're looking like people in the past.
Exactly.
They know what they're doing. But they're not doing anything hateful. So they can still pass it by. You know what I mean?
It's just passive.
It's very passive.
Yeah.
Not even passive.
If you ask me, it's kind of low-key passive-aggressive. It's like, okay, I'm going to do it. And so what? Everyone's going to talk about it. And that's it. Like,
exactly.
You know, but whatever.
So don't let them get you so riled up that you're like, oh, because they know what they're doing. Don't let them get to you. They know what they're doing. That's what I'm trying to say. Anyways, going on to the last chisme of the night it's not the last. There's two more. False Amber Alert. So, ladies, how far would you go to not go home? Because our 16-year-old homegirl in New York City has gotten things twisted. Her mom wanted her to move her family back to Honduras. Instead of complying, she had an amazing idea to stage her kidnapping with her 23-year-old boyfriend, sending the city on a rampage searching for her. How she did it was pretty messed up. Her boyfriend, who is also a member of a gang, got some of his friends and quote-unquote kidnapped her while she was walking down the street with her mom. Mom was literally screaming as they took her away. She may have gotten a guilty conscience because she eventually showed up unarmed at a park and a relative's house where she admitted to the police of the staging. So y'all know she's going to jail, right? The police are looking for the boyfriend and his friends but have not found him yet. Wait, she's for sure going to jail? I didn't know she was going to jail. So
I think they took her in. I think I saw a picture of them.
So that whole video.
So there's a few questions.
Of her getting kidnapped. That video that was on ABC7, that surveillance video of a girl walking with her mom and getting snatched into a car.
That's her.
Was this story?
Yes.
Yeah.
I think her name was Carol Sanchez.
Oh
they were
God.
With umbrellas, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. She needs her ass.
Yeah.
Back. Yeah.
I saw a GoFundMe to send her ass back to a loop. I think I put $20 on that shit.
Stop it. Oh my God.
Wow.
I mean, it's almost, would you say it's almost like, well, no. It's like almost like somebody running away from home.
You
it's
know
like
what?
Leaving.
I did see that on a, I think I saw it on the Shade Room. Good Lord. Shout out to the Shade Room. I mean, I started following you guys. You guys should just hire me and get me on your damn team. But I saw
extra.
That on the Shade Room. And somebody posted, she might as well have ran away. Like, that's what we used to do, right? And back in our days, like, you're not with my boyfriend. I'm going to leave the house. And then just leave the house and that's it, right?
That's
like,
too much.
That's
right.
Too much. Do you see how they manhandled? Well, I don't want to say they manhandled the mom. But, of course, the mom was putting up a good-ass fight trying to get her daughter. She jumped in the car. The guy grabbed her and threw her off the car. And she fell on the ground. And then the guy jumped on like, I know they were spooked. They didn't know that the mom was going to put up that much of a fucking fight. Like, literally, the mom was putting up a damn fight, as every mom should. But, yeah. Damn.
So, yeah, they had thrown the mom to the side of the walk, but because we took so much on the other one. But, yeah, just FYI, the girl, I think her name was Carol Sanchez.
Yeah.
She's fine. She's home. She just didn't want to go back to Honduras.
Of course she's fine. She didn't have some good sex. She didn't hang out with her gangster. Did you see how they put it on the social media? They said her gangster boyfriend, she wanted to hang out with him, and the parents wanted to go to Honduras, so they set up this whole thing. And then I guess she started feeling bad because she started thinking about her mom.
She was on the news, yeah. Mm-hmm.
And she was like, I gotta go back.
She probably didn't think she was gonna end up on the news. She probably she didn't know there was a camera on that sidewalk where they were gonna,
and she started seeing it like, damn, y'all treating my mom like that? Fuck you, motherfucker.
No, they probably just said, push her a little bit, not too hard though.
No, they didn't. That mom was fighting for her fucking daughter, let me tell you.
I know.
She jumped in the car and the guy didn't know what to do. She hit the guy so hard the guy lost his balance and almost fell. Did you not see the fucking video?
Yeah.
Yeah, that shit was hilarious.
Fabulous at 50. So Diddy just had his 50th birthday bash. Congrats to him for making it to 50. But did you know that he canceled it twice because he's been missing Kim Porter? Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Still though, he managed to pull it off with his friends such as Beyonce, Jay-Z, Leonardo DiCaprio, Post Malone, and many more. But the way he rescheduled it will make you cry. He set it around the date that would have been Kim Porter's 49th birthday, who passed away last year from pneumonia. So in a way, they both partied together in spirit. Damn, that's crazy.
Wow.
Did you see the memes about Jay-Z and Kanye, though? This was their reunion. They are seen hugging and talking, basically squashing rumors of beef between them. But there's one picture in particular that you can see Kanye walking towards Jay-Z. And I think who else was in the picture? Was it Diddy and Fabulous
and
or somebody?
Pharrell.
And Pharrell. And Jay-Z's just looking straight. He's not even acknowledging Kanye. And then somebody put up a meme that said something like, this is why I ask who's going to be there.
Who's all going to be
there? He's not even looking at him. He's just looking like, straight.
He's staring dead like.
Oh, my God. Have you ever been to a party where you ran into somebody that you're not talking to?
Man, why'd y'all drag me here?
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, I haven't.
What? Mm-mm. Lies.
No, I haven't.
Girl. Lies.
I have not. Why would I be lying about that shit?
I can say it, but I'm not going to put you on blast.
Put it on blast. I have not. Remind me. You know my what? Remind me. Who?
A family member that you were not talking to.
It's most of the time
and you showed
family.
Up and it was awkward for everybody and we're like, what's going to happen?
It's always family.
Yeah.
It's always like sometimes you're not talking to somebody. And
right.
All the time. Yeah. So.
I'm looking at Jackie like,
woo. I'm not going to put it out there. I'll tell you after this.
I have not.
Not going to put it out there.
But to add to that, I did see that his twins also had a birthday party. And he had that before them. So, yeah, shout out to Diddy. He's like under a lot, I would say, of pressure under these times. So, yeah.
Shout out to Lauren London. She
More
went.
Love to him.
Shout out to her.
Lauren London. I didn't see that.
She did like a whole new photo shoot and remade like a picture stick with Nipsey, which was nice. Man, I mean, I think right now during the holidays, like it's tough for a lot of people and like celebrities, but these 2 months, November and December, it's beautiful because it brings people together, but it's also months that remind you of the people that are gone and that you don't see anymore. And it's kind of like sad in a way. Yeah. That's why I kind of don't like November and December for those holidays. I don't know. Maybe it's just me. But anyways, moving on, we're going to play a quick game of, it's a new game that you guys actually have not played, but we're going to start it today. Y'all ready?
Yes! Hey.
All right, so Myra, you cannot look at the screen because I know you're sitting next to me, so you cannot look over here.
Okay.
I'm going to play some songs. Okay, Kosi, make sure Myra's not cheating.
She's looking.
Liar.
And the first person to... So pretty much I'm going to play a song and you guys have to tell me the name of the song and the artist. And
Oh, hell.
Should I have them say
I'm
their
name? I'm
not
good with that. Can I just sing it?
Should I have them say their name or should I do one person at a time? Oh, one person at a time. Okay, then we'll do with Maria first.
Wow. Okay.
Wait, what? Well, I was going to have them say their name on instead, but you think...
I don't know.
We're just going to do, okay, we're just going to do two songs.
She hasn't even started yet, and she's already
singing. I don't do well with music. Like, I just sing. I don't know the song names or the song people.
We haven't even played anything, and you're already tripping. What is wrong with you?
For real?
Can you just, like, not trip, please?
Okay.
Can we play the game?
I'm sitting, so I won't trip.
Okay. Please, please. All right, so who wants to go first? Rock, paper, scissors, go. Maria and Myra, rock, paper, scissors.
Ready? Rock, paper, scissors.
Two out of three.
Rock, paper, scissors.
Stop yelling.
That was Myra.
Okay, now Maria got that one. Rock, paper, scissors. Rock, paper, scissors. Rock, paper, scissors. Damn it, Maria. That's it. I'll go first because there's the
All right, forever. Don't look at the screen, Myra. Don't look at the screen. Please don't look at the screen. All right, so Myra's going to go first.
At the screen.
I'm going to play you guys both two songs, and you guys, the one that gets the most points will win. So you get 1 point per.
If she doesn't know it, can I be like, I know it?
No.
Oh.
You're just going to have to get the next song. So, all right. So, you get 2 points if you know the name of the artist and the song. You get 1 point if you know one or the other. Okay? So the one who has the most points. All right.
Okay.
Myra, you ready?
Okay. Yes.
I like how you're, like, trying your hardest not to look at the screen.
Here we
go.
Even though I already know that you already looked over.
She cheated!
I'm going to play 10 seconds of it. 10 seconds. All right?
Feliz Navidad.
So you have to know the name and the singer?
So you get 1 point if you give me the artist, and you get 2 points, or 1 point if you just know the artist, or 1 point if you just know the song name, or you get 2 points if you know both.
I'm just going to say the song is Feliz Navidad.
Okay, that's 1 point.
And the artist, I have no clue. I'm just going to say... Emilio something.
You so racist.
I had no clue.
Okay. All right. Myra gets 1 point. The artist is Jose Feliciano.
Almost.
Almost, girl. Okay.
Good job. Good job. Good job. Myra.
Myra gets 1 point. All right, Maria. You ready?
No.
All right. Here we go, Maria.
Oh, Lord. Traveling through the night. Whoa, this Christmas will be a very special Christmas.
All right.
You should stop it.
Chris Brown, This Christmas.
Ooh. Hey, you left that out too long.
No, if you watch my stories for Thanksgiving, you know that that's my song.
Okay. All right.
Hang, I think you're letting them play
the
too
mistletoe.
All right, Mara, your
over
turn.
Over my belt buckle.
We don't know this song.
All right.
Where'd you gave go? Me a song you knew damn well I wasn't going to know.
I'm glad you went first, though.
You're so mean.
Right. I know you're going to give it to me hard next time.
Santa Claus
is, oh, you know that,
up,
girl.
Shut up.
Oh, if you don't know that, I'm going to punch you in your throat.
You better watch.
Shut up.
It's not Michael Jackson. Thank it's the Jackson 5.
Okay.
Santa Claus is coming to town.
I was yes. trying to fuck her up, girl.
Yes. Ding, ding, ding.
Sit your ass.
All right. So right now the score is 3-2.
Hold the fuck up. How did Maya get through?
Because she got 1 point from last game,
oh, yeah,
and 2 points
behind
from
me.
Now.
I thought this was a conspiracy.
Oh,
okay,
my
go
God.
Ahead. Go her. Go her.
All right.
Go
you ready?
Okay, no, but okay.
All right, here we go.
Waiting all year for this man.
Don't look over here.
Snow is listening on the trees.
What the fuck?
Don't look
this. No, you gotta play this shit for like the whole song. What the fuck is this? No, play more.
And all the love will show. We'll see the gifts under the tree. It's the best time of year for the family.
the ceiling. It's that time.
Do you know that
year.
Song, Myra? Tell me the truth. Do you know that song?
I know who's singing it.
Above, God sent you with love.
Keep going. Keep going.
Well, I have to break it into parts enough. Because. And happy holidays.
No.
All right, Maria.
Starting from the top again. That's not fucking fair.
I'm sorry. I'm not here to be fair. I'm here to be. Oh, I am here to be fair, actually. But
okay, cool.
I've already played more. Like I played.
I
want to
hear the
seconds.
Voice. I obviously don't know the fucking name of the song.
I'm going to give you 10 more seconds, and Myra can steal it.
What? You did not say nothing about.
Well, you're not saying anything.
And all the love was shared. Everybody knows it's Christmas time, and all the people.
You
look
there. She cannot steal.
It's the best time of year for the family.
Okay, I don't want to get sued, so you have to already give it up. Come on, man.
That's not fair.
God
sent you his love. Okay, that's it. We played way too much for
I'm
you.
Gonna say
dear Lord, baby Jesus.
I'm trying to think about everybody that made a Christmas song.
Oh my God, that's a lot of people. Just a guess. So right now the score is 3-2. You have 2 points, Myra has 3.
That's
you can either
up.
You okay, you know what? She won't steal it. You either
I
win
will say
or she wins. I've already played way too much of this song.
It's a okay. Boy band.
It don't help sound, her.
It doesn't sound like.
Okay, sorry. It doesn't even count.
It doesn't sound like. Am I going to say NSYNC? Okay, hold up.
No. That's it. Your final say?
No.
Maria, we have to go on to the next thing.
Okay. It's a boy band. 5, 4, 3, 2. What is
people
want to
go on to the next topic?
Of?
People want
to
go into the next topic.
But boys.
Boys to men?
No, boys to men. No, I know damn well there ain't no damn boys to men. What is the other one? The
all right, that's
whatever.
It.
Whatever. That's
it. You have a final answer right now. Final answer. Just say it right now. Three,
something that has to do with boys.
Two.
I don't know.
One. Okay. No points for you then. What's your final answer? No, Myra doesn't get a steal.
No, we don't
get it's 3-2. 3-2. Myra doesn't get a steal.
The one with Justin Timberlake. No,
you have to just say the name.
Justin Timberlake is insane.
Boys something. Boys, they just had a
okay, look. I'm going to give you this. There's the Backstreet Boys, and then there's NSYNC. That's it.
Backstreet Boys.
Are you sure that's your final answer?
No, NSYNC.
Are you sure that's your final answer?
Yes, that's my final answer.
it was NSYNC.
Okay, thank you.
Merry Christmas, just happy holidays.
Just because you didn't hear.
I love you, Myra.
You didn't hear Justin Timberlake, that's
I did
why.
Not hear
but
Justin
because
Timberlake.
I'm not trying to.
I get it, yeah. I get it.
Like
that's not a fucking song that I listen to, but okay. Okay, NSYNC.
Oh my God, that's the point, Maria.
It was JC singing the whole time.
That was the point.
And that on that part.
So we tied.
We didn't tie, boo.
You lost, yo. I played like a whole minute of it. And I had to break it up so we wouldn't get sued. Oh, my God. You're horrible. You're so horrible. Anyways, and that wraps up game time.
That's a good game.
Oh, my God. Let's just go into
that
the topic.
Was really good.
I cannot.
Sorry, that was really good. Thank you.
Thank you. All right. So we're going to go ahead and jump into, before we go into the topic, question of the night by Myra.
Hey.
Oh, shit, Myra, I forgot to put up your music. Awesome. You want to just do it?
Girl, I got a question for you.
Hey. Can I get an answer? Hey.
I don't think he says it like that, but okay, it's fine.
Oh, this is what the fuck I say.
Ooh, I see that. Jesus. That's why you not Chris Brown.
Okay, guys.
If I was laying on my back, I would.
No, you were not. I don't know.
No, we don't want that.
No. Please don't.
Yeah, I saw how you was commenting. You commented on this picture.
You
so
saw
I'm
that?
Like, girl, boo. I was like,
stop
Chris,
it.
I know her if you. Okay.
Come to my show, Chris Brown.
Okay, here's the question of the night. Would you rather end the life of a single human being or 100 cute baby animals?
Wait, what?
I know.
I have to kill one or the other?
Okay. That's the same shit you said the last time we were together.
No, I didn't. I said something completely different. You don't even remember.
Yeah, would you save one person's life or 1,000 or 100 people's lives?
I said one person that you're close to or 5 strangers.
Yeah.
Would you rather end the life of a single human being or 100 cute baby animals?
Oh, my God. Is a human being like an evil person who it like could be anybody murder? Okay. Then if it's a murder, I'm going to say a human being.
Yeah. That's a good one.
See, or a pedophile or something.
This question is brutal.
You got Keith laughing at you. Maria.
Who, me?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, Keith. What's going on, yo?
He was laughing because I was telling you to speak up on who the family member that you were saying that I, yeah. That
anyways, one. Go ahead.
You killing the animals or what?
I think I'm with Jackie. You know, I'm all for love and peace, but if this motherfucker going crazy and killing people, then yeah. All
right, cool. All right, moving forward. Oh, you take forever to answer one question. One question. You're like, take 100 minutes.
I'm all not right. killing any animals.
So she going to kill a human being.
I'll murder somebody.
Yeah, for sure. But I don't know if I could actually murder somebody.
I know. Maybe poison like, them.
Yeah, I don't want to, like, actually do the work. Like, you know, stabbing takes a lot of work. A shot in the head.
Shoot them.
Maybe, but, like, stabbing, that's a whole lot. Choking somebody, that's a lot of work. Something that's less work.
Something you'll get less time for.
Oh, what's less time?
Damn. I think we'll get less time for killing 100 animals. What if we kill 100 ants?
I don't give a fuck. Listen, if those 100
that's not an animal, it's an insect.
If those 100 baby animals are coming like the gremlins did in that movie, like the crazy ass motherfuckers, they all going to die.
What if you kill 100 rats?
Ooh, yes. Get rid of those
babies. I don't
babies.
Do well with rats.
No.
Huh?
Right.
All
right.
No, exactly. So I'll kill the rats. They're rodents.
There's no consequences, so that doesn't really count as a baby animal. Because rats don't have rights. That's all I'm saying.
Oh, well.
That's cold. Okay, why do rats have rights?
I know, right?
No, because, we're like, it just seems hard to kill animals. We don't want to kill
what
animals.
What if you kill turtles?
You're saying rats don't have
rights.
No,
not the turtle. So there was a wild hog on my trip in New Orleans. And I learned that there's more killings from wild hogs than there are sharks. So do you know that if the wild hog in, like, the swamps, not the pigs over there in the Bahamas that swim with you, but the wild hogs in the swamps, if they feel threatened by you, they will attack you to kill you, and they eat you. Ooh. And there's more wild hog killings than there are shark killings. So when that wild hog came to our boat, I was like, oh, hell no. But they were not threatened by us because they always see that boat driver, the guy that we were with, and he always feeds him, so that's why he was the wild hog was calm. But
hell no, if your ass jumped off that fucking
right,
boat,
no, they,
he
that's
would
what
be
they
like,
said.
Boom.
Yeah, because you're in the boat, you're fine. But yeah. If you were to jump in and they feel attacked, they're gonna attack you to kill you, and then they eat you.
Right.
So yeah, don't mess with those wild hogs, y'all. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and jump into our topic. Myra, why do you do that to us, girl? That is not right.
Sorry.
All right. All right, so pretty much, am I the only person that gets booed up when goes on vacation? So have you guys ever, well, you said no, Maria, but Myra, have you ever been on, like, a vacation and, like, got booed up?
I met someone on vacation before, but I didn't get booed up.
Okay, well, that's what I mean, though, yeah. Like, when I say booed up. Like, you meet somebody and you guys are what? You exchange numbers, you talk, you're texting.
Yeah, you just kind of, like, you know, someone to, like, kind of hang out with, but... You don't stay too close because you're on vacation, so you kind of want to just do you too, you know?
Right.
See, that's when you say boot up, that's what I imagine. I imagine you're boot up for the whole vacation your boyfriend for a week. But
okay, then maybe I'm saying it wrong.
That's what I imagine.
So when I say boot up, I don't mean like you're like spending the time with that person the whole time you're at the trip, even though sometimes that could happen. What I'm saying is you meet somebody... And you guys exchange numbers and you guys are like texting and then out of nowhere you like probably link up a few times.
Right. Okay.
So that's what I mean. Right. I don't know. Mm-hmm. I don't know. Maybe boot up is not the right word. So I'm going to go back to the storytelling of New Orleans. And I know that you guys haven't heard this story, Myra, mm-hmm. but pretty much what happened was the first night that I was not even going to go out, I ended up going out and, like, we were bar hopping. And, like, about the seventh bar that we were at, like, I was tired. So I sat down. I sat on this chair, and I was like, I'm not getting up. Like, I'm tired. Like, I need a break. It's already, like, 2-something in the morning. When are we going home? But I was still having a good time. I was just tired. So then a group of guys walked past me and my friends. And there was, like, a group of us. There was, like, 5 girls and, like, 2 guys that were with. But the 2 guys went to the bar, and, like, 2 of the girls went with them and to get drinks. And I remember one of them asked me, like, what do you want to drink? And I told them. They're like, okay, I'll get you. And so me and, like, 2 of the other girls stayed behind, and we're, like, standing there. And then all of a sudden, like, this group of 5 guys walked by us. And out of the 5 guys, like, 3 of them were handsome, and they caught my attention. Yeah, like, 3 of the 5, you know.
I mean, that's the majority.
Why are you looking like that? What are you majority. Saying? Right, majority. Not all of them are going to be my type. How about that? They were not my type. But 3 of them, I was like, okay, they're cute.
60%.
Right. And so then they walk by, but then one of them happened to stop right where we were, like, standing and sitting. I was the only one sitting. No, actually, my friend was the only one standing. The rest of us were sitting on these chairs against the wall because it was, like, a small pathway to get to the bar. And so then one of them stops to talk to one of the girls that I was with, who happened to be single too. And they start talking, and as they're talking, I'm like, oh, he's cute. Like, okay, get it. Like, he's cute. Whatever. That was it. And so then the other girl that is, like, you know, in a relationship, she came and she's like, Jackie, here's your drink. And I'm like, cool, thanks. I got my drink. I'm chilling. Like, I'm not even focused on anything, but I was just like, I did say, like, oh, they're cute. I didn't say it out loud. I said it to myself. And then they brought me my drink, and we're all hanging out. And then the next thing I know, I don't know how. Oh, I do know how. One of his other friends, okay, there was 5 of them. So one of them stayed behind, and then they all went to the bar. And then one of them came back that was ugly. Okay. I don't want to say ugly. I want to say not my type.
He wasn't your type.
Not my type. So he came, and he was, like, kind of, like, trying to see what's going on, right? So he came. So now it's 3 of them, right? So it's my friend, one of the hot guys, and then one of the not-so-hot guys that I thought was not hot. And so it's 3 of them talking. And so I guess, like, in one of those, I'm, like, having my drink. I'm just, you know, I'm looking, but I'm also, like, enjoying, like, the dance floor, like, watching. And I'm, like, chilling. I was talking to one of my girls next to me. And then one of the guys, the cute one, that was talking to her, he happened to make eye contact with me. And, like, and he said something, and I didn't hear what he said.
He liked what he saw.
Well, whatever it was. And so he said something, and I was like, I didn't hear what you said. So he stepped away from my friend and got closer to me, and then he repeated what he said. And I was like, oh. And then I just answered it, and, like, it was literally, like, a friendly conversation. Like, it wasn't anything. Like, he was just making conversation. And then when I got up, because, like, I felt like it was rude that I'm sitting down and he's talking, so I was like, fine, I'll get up. So when I got up, I was wearing a shirt that had some writing on it. It was actually, shout out to For My Home Girls. It was one of those shirts. It said, self-care is gangsta. And I was wearing it because I just got off the airport anyways. And he's like, let me read your shirt. And I had my purse across it. So he kind of moved my purse so he can read it. So he kind of, like, you know, like, yeah. He, like, so he can read my chest. And so I was like, oh, it says this. It's my friend's clothing brand. Da, 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 whatever we're talking. And then we just kept talking. And the more we talked, the more we were vibing. We're flirting. And then my group of friends were like, okay, we're going to another bar. Like, we were literally bar hopping. I was like, oh, again. I was like, I'm sorry, we got to go to another bar. He's like, wait, before you leave, can I have your number? And so I was like, my number? I was like, are you sure you want my number? He's like, yeah. Because remember, he was talking to my friend before me. And then he was like, yeah, I want to talk to you. I want your number. I gave him my number. And then they were like, why are you laughing?
Because why? You, like, stumbled on your thought. Let me skip
I'm trying,
that part.
No. There was nothing. Like, I'm trying to remember how the night went. And I was sitting the whole time, and I was standing. And then, like, anyways, I gave him my number. And then he's like, well, where are you guys going? I was like, I don't even know. He's like, well, we'll go with you guys. And I'm like, okay, sure. Come with us. Because we were literally just bar hopping. And then they walked out first because they wanted to tell the rest of their buddies that they were with that they were going to come with us. And I guess me and my girls were behind, and the guys that I was with started walking ahead to the next bar. So two of the girls that I was with, they were walking with me, and we passed by them, but I don't think they saw me. This is what he tells me. He's, oh God, he's hilarious. He said that
look
some
at her over here blushing.
Yeah. I know, because I don't want to sound like conceited, but he pretty much was like, I saw this guy checking out this girl, and then out of nowhere, I see what he's looking at, and this girl with this like curvy big booty, and then he's like, I realize it's you, because he's like, I didn't notice you had a big butt until
you got up.
Until you got up.
Until I saw him looking.
Right. And so I was like, oh God. And so anyways, we went to the different bars, but we ended up going home all like at 3 something in the morning. So the next day he was like, not me and him, but me and my group of friends, he was texting me like the next day, just good morning, like throughout the whole day, and we had things planned. So like that's what I mean, booed up, like when you're like texting somebody or like stuff,
it gives
so.
You like this cute little feeling while you're on vacation.
Yeah,
like, it's like something to kind of look forward to on top of your vacation.
Exactly.
Like, oh.
So we literally had our whole trip planned, so it's not like I had time to go like on a date while I'm who goes on dates on vacation. Like I know people who do that, but I was like, I can't, because I'm like, I want to spend time with my friends that I came with. But he did ask me to go out a few times, and I was like, nah, we have this plan. So he ended up just kind of adding himself to our plans, and, you know, that's what happened. But it kind of like – so anyways, it was a cool trip. He was really nice. It was fun. We still have numbers. Like, we're still texting, but
where
it's nothing crazy. You wouldn't even believe – it's so random. It was like – I thought at first he was in Cincinnati, but he was from Connecticut or something like that.
Wow.
Yeah, so it's like on the East Coast. But it was really nice. It kind of gives you something to look forward to in your trips. And he did come out and hang out with me and my friends. And it was fun. It was a good time. But my question for you guys, really quick to go into the topic, is if you meet someone who catches your eye and you start flirting and talking to them, kind of like what he did, he was talking to my friend, and then maybe dating them, then you meet their friend either that day, a week, or a month, or 6 months after talking or dating them, is there a way to successfully move on to their friend? Kind of like what he did, but his happened to be that same night. Is there a way to successfully move on to their friend? Because you can, like, let's say you meet somebody, but then, like, that person, I feel like everybody, it comes to your life for a reason. What if you're like your soulmate or somebody that you really are vibing or that you connect more with happens to be their friend? Is there a way to successfully move on to their friend? Or do you just kind of have to like, that's it? You lost the chance there. Maria, you made a face. What's your
thing
on that?
Well, before we move on, we're going to move on. But I just want to give a shout out to everybody that's in the chat box.
What's up?
We have Bebe in the chat box.
Hey.
Bad News Radio. We also have Keith Good News, and we also have Nick's Fan 1235.
What up?
He said, what's up, ladies? He said,
hey.
You don't force it. You just go out and you do what you do. He said, but Jackie be getting it.
I see.
Yeah,
he said, Jackie be getting them. I see. Oh.
We're looking at it. Like, why do you keep repeating that?
Because it was jumping on my phone. You know, on my cell phone. I didn't bring my laptop. So
what happened? This happens all the time. Like, when I go on vacation, I end up meeting somebody that I'm vibing with, and we connect. And then, yeah, like, it's weird. Like, that's why I say booed up. But
so what did your friend say? Was she into the guy? Or?
So she... Well, it happened so fast.
Yeah.
Like, so she didn't have time
you
to be into him.
You don't have time to say anything.
Right.
Yeah.
And but then his friend started talking to her. And his friend started vibing with her, even though she wasn't really vibing with the friend.
Like,
so
she
ended up telling me that she's like, I decided to talk to his friend because I wanted you to keep talking to him because mm-hmm. I thought you guys were vibing. So she was cool with it. But she was like, I took one for the team, Jackie.
She
and I was like, I appreciate it, girl. I appreciate it. But they were having fun. It's not like he was like boring. Like, he was still fun. He just wasn't as appealing as the original, the first guy. Yeah. And so she was really cool about it. I think, you know, if it was my first,
the other way around,
I would have been the same way.
Yeah.
But yeah.
So what you're asking is, if we were the third wheel, would we be vibing with the...
No.
So what were you asking?
She was asking if you're feeling like, let's say the guy was talking to her friend first,
mm-hmm.
and then he went and started talking to her. Like, would you...
Like, it happened
that night.
But what if it happened a week after, a month after? Like, what if he met her first and they went on a few, like, 3 dates, and then, like, a month later he met me and he's, like, more into me? What is that, like, is there a successful way to, like, move on to their friend? That's what I'm saying.
That's tricky, huh?
It is tricky. That is tricky. Because let's say they're not boyfriend, girlfriend, and then you met them, but then you feel like you met them, maybe, you know, faith brought you guys and to meet their friend. Because, like, maybe that's somebody that you are vibing more with, or that could be your soulmate, or whatever it is.
Yeah, like, for example, your situation, what if he would have kept talking to your friend, but caught his eye, and he didn't say anything to you, and he kept talking to her, but later was like, you know, I was really feeling you at the bar, I wish I would have come and talked to you.
Exactly.
2 months later, you know?
Exactly.
And they'd already been talking. At that point...
But he was very smooth about it that night. He was very smooth about it that night.
I'm glad he did that, because what if he wouldn't have, and then he would have... Exactly. What if he would have been from California and then things would have, you know?
Exactly.
At that point, I think it would be a conversation between you and your girl.
Really?
Yeah, and be like.
Even though she wasn't vibing him?
No, we don't know.
She didn't have enough time to know if she was vibing him, because it happened so fast. Because it happened that same night within that time period.
What if he comes up to you and tells you, hey, you know, I'm really feeling you.
Right.
But I'm talking to your friend. Mm-hmm. Aren't you going to feel some kind of obligation to kind of tell your friend, or like, what are you going to do?
In that case, yes. But I'm just saying, like, let's say they went out for 2 weeks and then, like, he meets me and then he's like, whoa, I'm vibing more with her. Let's say they've only, within 2 weeks, they've only gone on like 2 dates. And then you guys go on a group setting, and then he meets you for the first time. And it's like, you guys are vibing, even though, like, he's on a date with your friend. They've only been on 2 dates for 2 weeks. But you guys are vibing, and you're both single. Stop chewing gum in the mic.
I think that...
Ew.
You're a hot mess.
I'm like that child that listens to her mom. Like, okay, let me pull it out real quick. Hey, that's what she said.
Oh, my God. What is wrong with you?
Okay, so I think that... If your girl is dating him for 2 weeks and then you like, okay, this guy is feeling me. He says that he really wanted to be with me. It will create some type of like, damn, well, what other guys is she going to do that with? Because there's so many guys. I'm a firm believer that there's so many guys in, you know, in this world for you to like,
Let's say you went on a date with a guy twice, right? You don't know if you're feeling him yet. That's why you went on a second date to see if you are. Mm-hmm. But then this time you're like, hey, I don't know if I'm feeling him that much. Let me bring all my girls. He can bring his friends. Let's all just kind of do a group type of thing. And everyone is socializing and he starts vibing more with your girl than you. How would you feel? Would you be like, you know what? Well, I wasn't really feeling him like that. They seem like they have more chemistry and let that be. Or would you feel some type of way?
Me personally, I mean... I'm all about trust, so I'm like, I'd be like, damn, girl, like, I didn't bring you around to get on my man, but I wouldn't either. If it would go to that extent of you, like, you guys end up, you know, dating and getting married, like, are you going to invite me to your wedding?
Yeah, 2 weeks. I would look at it like this. If he started,
just imagine in those 2 weeks, like I'm just that hoe, and I just be like having.
And this to make you a hoe.
No, I'm saying if I'm that hoe friend that sleeps with them is what I'm trying to tell you. Like I'm putting more extras on it. Like I slept with now your future husband. Are you gonna invite me to your wedding?
Okay, first of all, you're like you're going way too deep into it.
It's the truth, because that's now what these kids do. Like so, they be like having sex at the fucking first night.
Okay,
like, come
but
on
that
now.
Doesn't mean that doesn't make you a hoe.
Okay, okay. Well, let's just say I had sex with him.
Okay,
are you gonna invite me to your wedding, knowing that I had sex with your future
husband?
It
depends on our relationship, but yeah, I think I would, because at the end of the day, I don't look at sex the way like other women look at it. Like, oh my God, it's more like. It's an act of that people do when they're in relationships. But at the end of the day, not all relationships.
2 weeks is not a relationship.
But okay, but you're dating, and
it
sometimes
was just
that
a
happens.
Sexual
relationship. Dating now is different, Maria.
Cozy wants to say something.
Producer
Cozy
be getting so amped up, and she want to say something, and she don't
can't
say
finish,
it.
She can't
say
ever it. Finish her sentence.
Just say it, Cozy. Look, we won't say nothing. Go.
Okay. Look, the way that I would say is. If you guys are in a like social setting and he does start kind of talking to your friend and everyone's vibing and they hit it off more, that should just go to tell you like, okay, maybe he wasn't really feeling me or our chemistry wasn't there. you shouldn't try to force that after that.
I get that.
That would be one of those things, okay, this is a sign, let's right. wash my hands with it. Because then at that point, then it'll be there'll be some drama. You know, that would be like, okay, cool. That was our second date, and maybe he wasn't really feeling me like that, and that's it.
I get that, but for me, I guess I'm just a little bit more old school. Like, most relationships or most dating relationships in the second week do have sex. Like, within the first date, they have sex.
That's common.
So let's just say within the second,
John Legend and Chrissy Teigen, they had sex on their first date.
Okay.
First date.
And then they invite, I invite my friends, and then, like, you come, and now it's like this guy that I thought, like, okay, we cool, but we not really 100% cool, is now interested in my friend, and my friend's like, oh, we hit it off good. Like, I like him, too. Like, I'm going to be like, well, I get
it. Are you into
that? No. But I'm going to say I get it, but then, like, how many guys can I bring around you? Because, like, I'm just saying, like, damn, but every guy that I bring around is
no, we didn't
like
say
this?
That.
No, but
we
why
didn't
would
say
you
that.
Make it about her? If he's
I'm gonna
the
make it
one,
about both of them.
If he's the one,
both he's then, not then, good, then and then it's also it, gonna make me question my friend who I brought around. Is what I'm saying. That's just what
I think you're making too much of it. I think that's what it is too. I think you're adding extras on it because, like, let's say you're not even vibing the person. Like, let's say you're not even into them. Let's say they're not your match. Let's say you're not into them. You guys went on two dates. Maybe you shared a kiss because you want to see if it's there. But at the end of the day, you're not that into them. And you're not vibing or connecting with them.
I'm not about sharing either, though.
Okay, but it's not about sharing.
I get that.
It's not about sharing, but it's more about, like, okay, if you know your friend is single and you went on two dates with this guy.
And then I go on a date with
him. And then
him,
they meet and then they're vibing. No, listen. No, maybe it's not even your date. Maybe they met at the gym and they're vibing. You're going to feel some type of way. Like, even though you're not even into them. Listen. Can I finish? Even if you're not into them, like, you went on two dates, you're like, it's okay. And then they meet and then they're vibing and they have, like, a really strong connection. You're going to feel some type of way because you shared a kiss with them or.
So I have two questions. One. Does my friend know that this is the guy that I dated twice?
Maybe
I went out on two dates.
It could be yes and no.
And then two,
yes and no.
How serious is girl code with my friend?
That's you brought up a good point because we haven't talked about girl code.
Right.
When it comes to that. So, yeah.
So, those are the two
major
questions.
Let's use Cosi as an example. Let's say Cosi and you guys, your relationship, your friendship, and you go on a second date, and it's a group date, and he brought some friends, and you brought Cosi, me, and Myra, and we all go, but then, like, we're all sitting there, and, like, he makes a joke, or she makes a joke, and they're laughing, and, like, they have a stronger connection than you. Let's say that. Let's say that we can all
that
see
breaks
that.
That breaks.
That doesn't break girl code yet. That doesn't break girl code yet because she hasn't done anything. She's literally just showing
flirting
you.
With my man.
No, not even flirting.
You claiming a man.
Right. He's not even your
that's
man.
That's probably.
I'm having sex with him.
No, girl.
And we feeling each other.
That's probably
we are somewhat connected.
You know what?
No.
That explains
no.
it.
Maybe
that's
just,
probably why he started flirting with Cosi because your ass already claiming him and want to get married. And you only known him for two
I'm
weeks.
I'm a Sagittarius. Yeah.
Wait,
Cosi
has something to say.
Question. Can I ask a question? What is your definition of girl code?
Okay, so you're Leo, and Leos are very territorial.
No,
you gotta do the girl code.
No, listen, Leos are very territorial.
Oh my god.
Okay, so if you have dated this guy, mm-hmm. went on two dates, and you've had sex with him those two dates, mm-hmm. and then you bring him around me. And then all of a sudden, he's, like, flirting with me and doing me. I know you, Cosi. You might be like, whatever. Like, if that's what he choose, that's what he choose. But inside, you're not going to be mad so much. You're going to be mad at our friendship. Like, Maria, you, like, dude, like, what you doing?
I mean, it's like they said. It really depends on the relationship that I have with this person. If we were just fucking, then I wouldn't.
I don't know. I'm different. I'm just like,
look, I think it's on a case-to-case basis.
Yeah, it is on a case-to-case for sure.
For me, I feel like, look, like if I'm going to trust you, I want to make sure I trust you 100% before you go to like,
so
hey,
somebody
I'm
in the chat
guy.
Box
Hold
said,
on.
What's a girl code? And I want to really quickly tell you, a girl code is definitely respecting each other's friendship. So
and
like,
boundaries.
And boundaries. But like, if you know, if I'm the girl that I went on the date with two guys. If I went on the two dates. Well, you know, two dates on with a guy, and I feel like, okay, we made out. We might have had sex, whatever you want to say. But I just know, like, is this the one for me? And I'm still having doubts. And then I see that he's having a stronger connection with Kosi. I probably would respect. This is a girl code. Girl code, Kosi should come talk to me like, hey, yes, Jackie, yep. I know your date.
Yes.
But you didn't ask that. You didn't let us finish that.
You made him your husband.
You just made him your husband and said, all hands off. No. That's what you did. Yes, you did. No. Yes, you did. You said, you better not look at him.
But you're saying that you had a bigger connection with him, and then you guys, but you know, are hitting it off. And damn, you ain't even coming to me like, hey, Maria, like, okay, what's up with you? And
so wait, did I break the girl code for that same night? Did I break the girl code?
I was in the restroom, so I didn't get to hear.
Because the guy was talking to the girl. I don't even know if they were flirting because I didn't hear their conversation. His friend came over, so now it's three of them. It's my friend, the guy, and now his friend. And then when all three of them were talking, he happened to ask me a question. I'm sitting down against the wall, not even in their conversation, but he asked me something I couldn't hear because of the music. And he came closer to me and he asked me the question again. And then I answered him. And then we were talking. The next thing you know, fast forward, we're leaving. I'm like, oh, I gotta go. We're going to another bar. He asked for my number.
Okay,
but he was talking to her friend first.
Yes.
But that and same night, and I he never, came up to her. No, you didn't break any type of girl code.
No. And that's what brought me to this question for everybody, because it could be a week, it could be 2 weeks, it could be a month. We don't know. You know, I don't even know how she really felt about him. And I never once asked, like, hey, are you okay if I give him my number? It just all happened that same night.
Yeah, she doesn't know him.
Exactly. Right.
So no.
And then 2 weeks, you kind of don't know somebody, but people have sex with each other, but they don't really know each other.
So you're giving me two different situations. Right.
So that's what I'm saying. 2 weeks, the first a night, month, 2 weeks. Yeah. Months,
her original question was how long.
Girl code, Nick's fan 1235. Bro code is if you mess. It's the same as bro code. If you messing with somebody, I think that it'll be out of respect to go and ask that person.
I will say, like, this:
hey, are you serious with this person, or are you just having fun? Because this person seems like they feeling me too, and then you guys can talk about
it. Yes,
and
for
there
sure.
will not be any like.
But you weren't saying that in the beginning. You were just like, because, "That's my man." And it's like you've only gone on two dates. How is that your man?
Hey, a lot of people fuck on the first date, like you said.
That doesn't mean he's your man. You guys had sex does not make him your man. Does not mean your claws are in
Jackie,
him.
Jackie, I get it, but there is some. If I give my body to somebody, we doing something.
What happened? Girl code. If you're close friends with the girl, you aren't allowed to FW any of her exes.
Fuck with.
Or anyone that they had a thing with if it lasted for longer than 3 months.
Okay, so three
and
months.
And I gave her 2 weeks, and she was like, don't talk to my man.
I'm saying, but look, I'm old school, so I don't really, like, you know, fuck with. Like
so
that.
Then you so hopefully whoever I you're do, dating in those 2 weeks is old minutes. School like you, because there's a lot of people that are not like that. So if you gave your body to somebody in those 2 weeks and they
you
don't
better come and ask Myra.
And they're not old, no.
So Nick's fan asked, would you date someone? Would you date someone?
You know me. I'm.
Would you
I'm
date?
Just saying.
Listen. Would you date someone your friend smashed?
Wait, and what? Jackie needed clarity just in case she's like, let's establish this right now, y'all. Let me know.
So, actually, Myra can tell you, the guy that I used to, like, not used to, but, like, I hooked up with, like, maybe twice. Like, I was not into him, like, to date, but, like, we had fun, whatever. And I was like, oh, Myra, like, such and such, you know, said what's up. And Myra was like, ew, Jackie, like, no. But I'm just saying, like, I'm giving, that was my girl code, like, saying, like, I'm not into him. I don't want him. Because it was fun. But at the end of the day, yeah, I put you down.
But Jackie knows me, though. So she was like, right. Okay, you're right. You know,
no, but I know
you're
her.
Not going to.
It's not just you, boo. It's just sometimes these men try. Can people hear me? Even
yeah,
though
they can hear you.
Sometimes these men try to get over on us as women. And
which
as
is why
friends,
I communicated.
And, you know, they're like, okay, now I like your friend. Now I tasted what you tasted.
He had
like.
No chance.
So, yes, right. Thank you.
Yeah.
But my thing for you is, like, 2 weeks, you went on two dates.
No, I'm just saying, look.
And Kosi was vibing more with him. You're not going to let him have, like, hang out with Kosi?
Let me know, Kosi.
That's it.
Let me know. That's what I'm saying. If I had sex with you on the fucking first night, then he's going to start playing with us. Now he's going to go and dip in with Kosi.
Not if you communicate. If you communicate.
Exactly. Communicate. Kosi got to come and let me know. Hey, Maria, this guy tried to let me know. And then I'll be like, oh, he a douchebag. Okay, Kosi, have your fun.
Oh, why he gotta be a douchebag? See,
he might
because
be.
He maybe. Might
what
be.
If he was a douchebag to you? What if he was a douchebag to you?
Listen, he might be. If he is still dipping in my pond and now he's flirting with me,
dipping in my pond?
Skinny dipping in your pond, girl.
Hey, I'm done with y'all.
No, never no skinny dipping.
Oh my god, today
you better
was
wear a life
so
jacket.
Fun. Oh my god. Oh my god, it was fun for sure. It's good to be back on the mic. Just FYI, we might be doing a remote show next Friday. Stay tuned. It'll be in Elsa. No, not Elsa.
Damn,
no.
Time flew by fast.
Right,
9 o'clock.
I know. That's what happens when you're having fun. But if you guys want to catch us live, I mean, it's not a live audience show, but I'm going to set us up for a remote show next Friday. It's going to be in Redondo Beach. Hit us up. It'll be a good time. But anyways, if you want to catch us tomorrow, we're going to be in downtown LA at Down and Out. It's we're taking donations. We are collecting brand new socks and underwear.
Yes.
Still in the packaging for the homeless. We plan to take the donations to Skid Row in downtown LA on December. This Sunday. And if you're interested in helping, please send us a message on Instagram at Ladies Night Radio Show. But you can also bring your socks and underwears, the new ones, to Down and Out in downtown LA. Find more information on our Instagram at Ladies Night Radio Show. So thank you, everybody, for tuning in. Ladies, you guys go ahead and give your social media. Where can they find you?
You can find me on Instagram, MEERAH, the number 8, Mira 8, on Instagram.
You can find me at Crazy Maria with the double A and an underscore at the bottom at Instagram. I also want to say, yes, please give out to the homeless, please. It is really cold right now. And you know that if you are in your room and you're freezing, you know they are as well. I also want to say Merry Christmas. Happy holidays. I brought you girls a little gift.
Oh, my God.
I didn't get to do my little skit today, but it was on self-care. So I brought you guys a little something, nothing big, but
awesome.
Just
thank
to let you girls know that I love you. Happy holidays. Yes. So much
thank
love.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Maria.
Thank you, Crazy Maria.
And I brought the little red. I don't know if you guys know the little red bracelet. I brought it from my trip, but I was never able to give it to you guys. And I had it in my truck. So it's supposed to keep all the negativity away. So make sure that you guys wear it. It is blessed. I blessed it myself. So
awesome.
Much love.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. All right. If you guys want more information on where you can catch the Ladies Night, make sure you follow us on Instagram at Ladies Night Radio Show and also on Twitter now, Ladies Night underscore RS. Oh, okay. Thank you for everybody for tuning in. We appreciate you. We love you. Thank you for spending your Friday night with us. I'm your host, Mysterious Jax. This is Ladies Night Radio Show. And just remember one thing, ladies.
You are enough. We love you guys.
Do it precisely, because I'm a millionaire. This pussy pricey.
Yep, it might be.
He said it's my pussy.
Yep, it might be.
My pussy.